you. Good morning.
You know, you're going to be in the Boston area. I'm really excited. I'm going to be on the mixtape tour. I'm going to be in the audience watching you at the Garden on the 28th and the 29th. Yeah, that's going to be so cool. And then I know you're at Mohegan Sun on the 3rd of July as well. You know, what is it like being on stage now? How have the audiences changed over the years?
Oh, man, it's like a block party. And that's one of the themes of the mixtape tour. It's nostalgic. It's fun. You know, it's mostly women. Thank God for the men that bring their girlfriends.
Yeah, well, why do you think I'm going?
No, I could imagine so, but you did a good job by doing that. So good on you.
Yeah, right.
I know where. Have a great time.
Yeah, I know where it's at, girl. I get it. Trust me. You know what? It's funny. You can't be a good poker player because I got to tell you, I've seen footage of you. You're at the Las Vegas residency. Yeah, that must be you're standing there, and I can see on your face your facial expressions. You're loving every minute of it. As you should be, but there's something about the way you're acting on stage. You got to be standing there thinking to yourself, man, I can't believe that this has happened to me.
You know what? It's just so much joy that music, that time brings to the people. And so I just feed off of their smiles. You know, I'm just reflecting back to you guys what you're giving me, which is so much support and so much love and so much appreciation. So it's contagious.
Yeah, and you give it right back, Salt. You really do, and it's so different because I remember, you know, the late 80s, early 90s, and Push It was, you guys came on the scene with Push It, and it was like you exposed so many people to this new sound, especially from female rappers, which I can't remember thinking of any female rappers prior to that.
Yeah, that was our breakthrough record, which is so ironic because it was actually the B-side of Tramp, which was the song that we were promoting, but one of you amazing DJs just flipped that record over and it on your own, and it just caught on like wildfire. And on the tour, obviously, no shade to the new kids, that's one of the highlights of the night for sure.
Exactly. And you know, not to step aside from Push It, but you know, it's Shoop and What a Man. I think they kind of blow away Push It to some degree with your audience, right? I mean, which songs really are the ones that are the really crowd pleasers at this point? Because, you know, I started with Push It. I'm like, okay, I'm going to push it good, real good. But, you know, What a Man seems like a party anthem for a lot of girls I know.
Absolutely, especially with all the women that we bring to the audience, the celebration of men. That was a breakthrough song for Salt and Pepper because usually, you know, we were doing records like Tramp and tongue-in-cheek songs making fun of guys, but this is the first time two iconic groups like In Vogue and Salt and Pepper came together and really celebrated all the great men out there, and so that definitely was one of them. But I would have to say the number one karaoke song is Shoop.
Is it really?
Okay. I do Shoop at karaoke, and that's the song that they basically sing the loudest.
Oh my God. You know, and I was watching some footage of Ladies Night, which I know is the finale of Ladies Night on BET is Tuesday, June 25th. So that's coming right up. And I'm watching you. Are you kind of the unintentional leader of everything you do? Because I'm watching, you know, early stuff from Salt and Pepper, and now, you know, with Ladies Night, it seems like you're the one that's kind of the glue of everything all the time.
Well, you know what? That's an amazing observation because that definitely was not intentional to show up that way. But the history with Salt and Pepper, we're actually our biopic with Lifetime that's being worked on now. I think that once you get the story, you know, because it started with me and my boyfriend, Herbie, and I've always, I've learned a lot from him, how to write, how to produce, and put shows together. And so I've always kind of just naturally taken on that responsibility as my own, you know, and I think the girls have definitely always been involved and contributed, but I'm a little bossy too, and I get that from my mom. I'm an Aries, but the creative process for me of putting something together, like a Vegas residency, producing it from the lighting to the sound to clothing, to it's my favorite part, being in the studio, so that's what it is for me, even more so than performing. I love the creative process.
Yeah, and, car.
Yeah, and we got to go. I know. Sorry about that. Thanks a lot, Salt, for being on the show with us. We really appreciate it. Again, you're going to be at the Garden on the 28th and 29th in Mohican Sun on July 3rd. Thanks for bringing us all the joy over the years.